Hi everybody, welcome back from spring break. I hope you had a good time and you're ready to get back to the action. Today in PE, we are going to do a new activity that requires a few items. First, if you have a balloon, that will be great. But if you don't have a balloon that you can fill up, instead, you can use a plastic bag that zips at the top, full of air, to do the same thing as a balloon does. I'm going to show you a couple of tricks, and I hope you can follow along or even create your own tricks, just like this guy. The first challenge we're going to do is keep the balloon up in the air as long as you can using your hands. You can pick your dominant hand, that will be my right hand, or you can switch to your non-dominant hand. That would be my left hand. Let's see if we can keep this going. Trick move. And spike it. Now, I want to turn this activity into a fitness game. Step one before all physical activity is to warm up. So let's make sure your arms and legs are ready to go, as well as your heart. Let's start. Okay, I think I'm ready. In the first challenge, there will be 1 minute on the clock. You need to keep the balloon floating for the whole minute to pass level one. If the balloon drops, you can still pass, but what you have to do is complete an exercise for the remainder of the minute, however much time is left. Maybe it's 30 seconds, maybe less. The better you do at keeping the balloon up, the less time you'll need to exercise. I'm gonna get started with level one. Level one is hands. Either hand can keep the balloon up. Let's get this started. Time to go for a trick. And another. Dropped it. Let's go into the exercise for the last 30 seconds. Squats. Good, we passed level one. Even though we dropped the balloon, I completed the exercise, so I'm on to level two now. For level two, I'll switch it up and use the bag. This way you can see that the challenge is a little bit different with a bag instead of a balloon. I'm going to use my feet this time for level two. You do it too. I dropped it already. Let's go into some lunges. 50 seconds. Okay, I completed level two with a lot of lunges. I hope you can keep that bag kicked up a lot longer than I can. I'm moving on to level three, and you need a wall for this challenge. You need to bounce your air-filled object against a wall before you touch it, like this. This should be a good challenge. I'll start a minute. Off the wall, level three. Ready, set, go. Time to change things up. Another leg exercise, jump squats. That's level three. Time to step it up to level four, coming up next. For level four, let's get another piece of equipment. It will be a paper towel roll that you can use to strike your object and keep it up in the air for 1 whole minute. Let's see if we can do it. And begin. Lost it. Okay. 40 seconds of exercise. I'm going into jump lunges, but you can do any kind of lunge if you want. Try to make it heavier or lighter. Level four is pretty tough for me. Now for level five. Level five will be two items, two different floating objects. I'll try with a small and a large bag to see if I can keep both of them up for 1 whole minute. If not, I'm doing exercise. You two, let's get challenge number five started now. Lost both. 10 seconds is all I could do. Could you do better? Now I have a bunch of seconds of exercise, so I'm going back to squats. There we go. Now let's try what I call level seven. No using your palms. Lost it. With 45 seconds left, another turn of exercise. Let's try a challenge with the lunges. Put 1 foot on a chair and lunge. Let's switch legs halfway through. Excellent work. I bet you can keep that balloon floating longer than I can, but let's try level eight. Okay, moving on to level eight. Hands behind your back. You could use the large or the small. I'm gonna give the large a try this time. 1 minute starting now. Lost it again with 45 seconds. Time for one more leg exercise. Side lunge. completed. We're moving on to level 9 now. Only 2 more levels and it's finished. For level 9, I'm gonna try sitting down in a chair. Could be a little bit easier on my legs, but I'll need to control the object a lot more so it doesn't get out of my reach. You cannot get out of the chair for level 9. Finally, I completed a level with no exercise. That's a good thing because I'm already sweating and a little bit tired. But now it's time for level 10, the most challenging of all. I'm going supersized for this one because the challenge is eyes closed. Let's see if it can be done. Fail. Looks like I'm doing 50 seconds of exercise, jumping jacks. There we go, we just completed 10 levels. I did a lot of exercise because I couldn't keep that object floating long enough, but I bet you can do it. And if not, get these exercises going because you need 60 minutes of physical activity every day. After that activity and noticing some sweat dripping, what is it I need? I need something to replenish my body, the fluids that are leaving from my body, so I need some water. What's the importance of water? You need it inside your body to keep you hydrated, to get your muscles and your cells the water that they need so that they can keep on working. If you're dehydrated, you'll notice it with a headache, weakness, dry mouth. But what we need is to keep replenishing the water that we lose so that we can stay healthy and continue our day. Water also helps regulate our body temperature. Cool water helps cool down our body, and in fact we need to make sure that our muscles get cool so they don't overheat. Let's do that with a few stretches to finish this fitness activity. Now my muscles feel a lot better after all those lower body exercises. I hope yours does too. Let's keep on doing these physical activities every day this week so we can stay healthy and strong throughout our time away from school. Exercise.